Hi, my name is Laura. I'm from Germany. I'm traveling through Canada right now. And yeah, I stopped in Yellowknife. And I just kind of want to share my experience, especially compared to what people told me I should expect in Yellowknife and what I actually experienced and saw. Well, I planned my trip here for 8 days. And when I came here, or before I came here, a lot of people told me it's a really, really small city. What are you doing in Yellowknife? Why would you go there? There's nothing to see, nothing to do. So my expectations were not that high, and I kind of, well, I was afraid I would just be really bored. But then I arrived in Yellowknife, and I actually, on the really first day, I saw Aurora, which was one of the reasons why I came here, which was amazing, which I personally think was already worth the trip here. And then after 1 or 2 days just walking around Yellowknife, I really quickly saw that most of the opinions weren't quite right. Of course, it is a small town, it really is, but it is charming and you could actually do a lot. In the background here is a snow castle. What I didn't know when I came here, that there was a snow castle and a whole festival for the weekend, the Long John Jamboree, which was a little surprise for me, which maybe made my stay a little bit more exciting and adventurous. And this is also why I chose this spot, because this is actually the place I spent most of my times when I went out. Of course, I walked through the city. It's a really nice small downtown. You have a few nice heritage museum. I went to two, and the government building, the legislature. Sorry, hard word for me to pronounce. But this is actually where I kind of experienced the northern life as well. There was a little typical thing, the Cabane de Sucre, which was a syrup, or syrup that was made on the ice or poured on the ice, and you have a wooden stick and just kind of roll it up, and you can eat it. And then it was toffee, or like a lollipop consistency, which was really nice to experience. And I don't know, there's just this huge festival that was going on with frisbee. I've never played frisbee in the winter, which was really, really nice. And what really blowed my mind was that what we are doing right now, we are standing on a river, on a lake, on the Great Slave Lake, which was a little scary at first, just thinking about standing on a lake, driving on a lake. But that was a really nice experience, what I did not think would happen. And if you see here, you can actually see the ice that is cracking underneath you. And that was a beautiful experience, a really nice northern Canada experience, standing and having a party or a whole festival on a lake. Which I've never thought I would experience in my life, and I came here, and that just really blew my mind. So they kind of built the whole festival on the lake, and I'm just really, really glad I got to experience that. Another thing which kind of made me realize I'm in the north, which I had in mind before I came here, was yesterday I went cross-country skiing for the first time, and we went on a trail, we went through the trees and over lakes as well, and at one point I just stopped and it was completely silence. The only thing you could hear is like a little bird somewhere there, and you were surrounded by trees, which you can't see right now because the trail is a few meters away, but it was so, so, so nice. You were on your skis, it was a little cold, but then you just stopped and it was silent. And that is what I experienced going in, or what I thought I would experience going to the north. And that was one of my favorite experiences here, actually, just being in the nature and by itself. And that is actually what a lot of people told me as well, that there's a lot of, not silence, but a lot of alone time. But I thought that was really, really beautiful. And if I would think about if I would have just listened to the people and wouldn't have come here, I would really regret it. Of course, I wouldn't know that I would regret it, but now thinking back, I'm really, really glad I made this trip. And from my opinion of, I would always try to get here if you want to experience Canada as well. Don't just do the normal touristy stuff, which I do, of course. I did all that and I'm still gonna do that. But I would recommend go to the north and see it as well, because it's worth it. I don't know how it is here in the summer, but if you're here around March and experience all this amazing festivals and the castle right behind me, it is 100% worth it.